Our top story tonight, a day after the Union Home Ministry refused a renewal of the Foreign Contribution Regulation Act license of the Missionaries of Charities, effectively denying the organization set up by Mother Teresa access to foreign funds, political battle lines have been drawn. The opposition parties are hitting out at the Modi government, claiming they are targeting Christian institutions. The BJP, in turn, is accusing the opposition of polarizing voters ahead of Goa elections, where there are a sizable Catholic community. Our top story tonight looks at just why has Mother Teresa's organization found itself under the Home Ministry's scanner, and what's the politics that's involved.
When alive, Mother Teresa was the embodiment of selfless service. The Missionaries of Charity, founded by her, has footprint in many countries, but India has been her karma bhumi. The institution now finds itself in the middle of a political controversy after the Narendra Modi government refused renewal of its Foreign Contribution Regulation Act license, which expires on December 31st. The decision, which was incidentally taken on Christmas Day, effectively blocks any foreign funds for the missionary. The Home Ministry, in a statement, said the missionary's renewal application was rejected after some adverse inputs were noticed. It did not elaborate what the adverse inputs were. The ministry said it has not got any revision application from the missionary. The government clarified it hasn't frozen any bank accounts belonging to the Missionaries of Charity, and added that the SBI froze accounts based on a request from the institution itself. The Missionaries of Charity also reacted. In a carefully worded statement, it said, "We have been informed that our FCRA renewal has not been approved. As a measure to ensure that there is no lapse, we have asked our centres not to operate any of the FC accounts until the matter is resolved." The clarifications came after West Bengal CM Mamata Banerjee tweeted, claiming the accounts of Mother Teresa's charity have been frozen by the centre. The controversy has triggered a political war. From Derek O'Brien to P. Chidambaram, various opposition leaders took to Twitter to criticise the government's decision. The most vocal criticism has come from the Trinamool Congress.
Once the Chief Minister came to know from the statement of the Archbishop of Calcutta that this has happened, so naturally she tweeted. There's nothing wrong in it. But what she said, apart from that the accounts was frozen, as it appears from the statement of Archbishop, she also said that while the law is paramount, humanitarian efforts must not be compromised.
The BJP has hit back at the opposition, accusing the TMC of an attempt to polarize voters in Goa, which is heading for polls.
This claim made by leaders like Mamata Banerjee, Mr. Chidambaram, have been dismissed by the NGO or by the organization itself. This propaganda and fakery is being peddled in order to give a communal spin just before the Goa elections.
On its part, the Trinamool Congress maintains that this is nothing but dirty tactics used by the government of India to intimidate Christian missionary organizations. However, the BJP, of course, has lapped up this opportunity to hit out at the Trinamool Congress, saying that the party is needlessly politicizing this issue. Clearly, the last word on this has not been heard, with the Goa elections around the corner. With camera person Praveer Biswas, Indrajit, for India Today in Kolkata.
So is the Modi government targeting Christian-linked NGOs, as critics allege? Does denying foreign funds to missionaries of charity send a wrong message globally? Is the Home Ministry justified in seeking financial accountability from all NGOs under FCRA rules? And is the issue being politicized because elections in states like Goa, with a large Catholic population, are around the corner? Just some of the questions we'll raise tonight. Joining me now is Priyanka Tibrewal, BJP spokesperson from Bengal, who took on Mamata Banerjee in recent elections. Saket Gokhale is TMC's spokesperson. And Reverend Dr. Valsan Thampu is a Christian theologian and former principal of St. Stephen's College. Appreciate all of you joining us. Let's come to you, Saket Gokhale, because the Trinamool Congress, in a way, was the one which triggered off this entire controversy. Mamata Banerjee tweeting at about 3 p.m. yesterday, shocked to hear that on Christmas, Union Minister Ministry froze all bank accounts of Mother Teresa's Ministry of Charity, that 22,000 patients and employees have been left without food and medicine. While the law is paramount, humanitarian efforts must not be compromised. It turns out that the accounts are not frozen, but they've been blocked. And it was voluntarily that Missionaries of Charity claim that they asked the State Bank of India not to transact their accounts till the FCRA issue was resolved. Did your Chief Minister jump the gun?
No, Rajdeep, most definitely not. I mean, number one, the letter that Missionaries of Charity put out, you understand the predicament that they're in. Because anybody, as an organization, they've been working with the most underprivileged of society. They've been working with lepers. They've been working with, people who have absolutely nobody in this world. This is not an organization that has ever even, remotely connected itself with politics. And every organization in India knows that today, if you speak one word against the government, you're going to go the way that Amnesty International went. So obviously that press release was, that's eventually they had to put that out so as to not, anger this government further.
The fact is that technically the accounts are not frozen. They are effectively blocked. The foreign funding is blocked. So technically the fact is that the Missionaries of Charity can continue to function on domestic funds.
Let me put it this way, Rajdeep. So 31st of September was when the FCRA licenses were expiring. Mm-hmm. And because of the COVID situation, the government of India had extended the deadline to 31st of December. Mm-hmm. Now, any application for renewal of FCRA has to be made at least 6 months before the deadline. Mm-hmm. So after an application is made 6 months before the 31st December deadline, is it a mere coincidence that suddenly on Christmas Day, 5 days before the deadline expires, the Ministry of Home Affairs wakes up and says there have been some adverse inputs? Mm-hmm. I mean, were they sleeping all this while?
Priyanka Tibrewal, the fact is it appears that there is a sustained campaign against Missionaries of Charity launched by the BJP. We've seen that in Vadodara, in Gujarat, where there is a BJP government, an FIR was launched against Missionaries of Charity claiming that the home run by the Missionaries of Charity, the girls there were being forced to read Christian texts, participate in prayers, intention of steering them to Christianity, bringing out the conversion debate. Similar arguments were made by Nishikant Dubey, your MP, in Parliament during the winter session. It seems that somewhere you are targeting Mother Teresa's Missionaries of Charity, which across the world is recognized for working among the poorest of the poor. I mean, for God's sake, why target Missionaries of Charity?
Well, very good evening, Rajdeep. I heard Mr. Saket from Trinamool, who just spoke now, and he spoke something about the timing. And I can accuse both the media, including you and Mr. Saket, of the same. That why such a timing of this discussion when we know that the elections of Goa are there? And so I will probably take this as a communal provocation from both your sides and the Trinamool, trying their best to woo out the voters. And let me also sensibly question something.
One minute. Before you go any further, what's the communal provocation here? The fact is, neither Saket Gokhale or me are in the Home Ministry, which has blocked the funds, foreign funds of Missionaries of Charity by rejecting their FCRA license. So we are not communalizing it.
You have just spoken about the letter which was issued from the Missionaries of Charity, which clearly states that it is not the Ministry of Home Affairs who have frozen their accounts. It was written by the Missionaries of Charity to the SBI to freeze their accounts. And they have also accepted that there are certain, in registration, there were certain eligibility criteria which they could not fulfill. Now, instead of having a complete discussion on this, they should proceed for the renewal to find out that why it was, as to why there was this refusal.
Priyanka Tibrewal, the point that I'm raising, I gave you instances where the Missionary of Charities have been targeted in the last month alone, where the BJP leaders are raising questions whether this organization set up by Mother Teresa is being used for conversion into Christianity. Somewhere, therefore, the presumption is that the BJP is targeting it because of its religious
character. No, not at all. That's a different topic at all. And what we are discussing here today is the conditions which they did not meet under the FCRA Act. Now, I have simple questions that NGOs or charitable organizations who are doing this work of charity, are they separate? The statutes or the acts, are they not relevant for them? Of course it is. We have to follow the land of the country. So if there are certain acts which speaks about certain criteria and conditions to be fulfilled, you cannot step out of that.
Okay, so I will persist, ma'am, by asking you, how do you, as a BJP leader in Kolkata, see the missionaries of charity? Do you see it as a charitable organization working among the poorest of the poor, or do you believe it is involved in conversion?
No. Now, I will tell you, I might have my own different view and the party may have their own different view. But this is not the topic of discussion today.
I'm asking you, do you agree with BJP leaders who are questioning the bona fides of missionaries of charity? Yes or no?
There are many such incidents where we have seen that this is happening. So it is not that it is not happening. And yes, I am personally associated with the missionaries of charity. I do a lot of charitable work along with the institution. So I do not deny that they are not into charity work. But again, these are two different topics which we are mixing at the moment.
You're claiming that the FCRA issue should not be mixed with the issue of the issue of conversion. Reverend Valsan Thampu, but willy-nilly, that's exactly what's happening, particularly because this has come against the backdrop of, over Christmas weekend, a series of instances where in Karnataka, in Assam, in other parts of the country, there have been attacks on Christian institutions, including church halls. What's your sense? Is the Christian community being a victim of fear-mongering at the moment, worried about some kind of majoritarian attacks? Or do you believe, as Priyanka Tibrewal is suggesting, this should be seen within the realm of law? Is missionaries of charity following FCRA norms or not?
Well, thank you, Rajdeep. I take this opportunity to greet all my fellow citizens with the Christmas message. Jesus came to preach the good news to the poor. And that's what Christmas is, and it's an interesting coincidence that this discussion should take place at this time. Now, what is the plight of the Christian community? First of all, this is not the first time that the Christian community has been targeted. Mm-hmm. There were waves of attack on the community in the past, and the details are in the public domain. I will not repeat some. The plight of an absolutely above board mission organization like Missionaries of Charity, mm-hmm. that has done stellar work, recognized all over the globe, is a matter of concern. Now, for the BJP spokesperson to say that there is no communal angle to it is extremely strange, because after all, the excuse given by the Ministry of Home Affairs for not renewing the FCRA account for the organization concerned is that there are certain adverse reports about the functioning of this charitable organization. And from available report, mm-hmm. these adverse reports pertain to allegations of quote-unquote forcible conversion or attempts or strategies to convert people. Now, let's recall for a moment that the allegation that Mother Teresa was doing charitable work merely as a cover-up to lure people from other faiths into Christianity has been in force for a very long time. I have participated in such discussions in the past. In this context, let me only recall a personal experience. In 1994, I visited the mother in the mother house in Kolkata, and I raised this issue with her. So immediately she called one Mr. Agarwal, mm-hmm. who was in the office, and introduced him to me and said that this Mr. Agarwal and his wife have sold all their personal wealth, contributed it to the Missionaries of Charity, and they're working as full-time volunteers with the organization. And the next sentence she said is something I should always remember. Then she said, Mr. and Mrs. Agarwal, remain as good Hindus now as they were before? So that was her answer to my question, whether there was any substance to this allegation. After all, Rajdeep, we are not unlettered people. We have a modicum of common sense. If an allegation that forcible or fraudulent conversions are taking place under the auspices of missionaries of charity, over about 30 years, three decades, shouldn't there be a shred of evidence to that effect?
But Reverend Thampu, there is one issue, therefore, which you are raising, where you are claiming that the conversion issue is being grossly exaggerated, is untrue, is one part. The other part, of course, is that the funding which is received by the missionaries of charity in the last 15 years, more than 1,099 crores from foreign sources. And the government says that as per FCRA rules, all NGOs now are being subject to much stricter scrutiny. Why are supporters of missionaries of charity making it an issue of a Christian institution being targeted? They claim, as Priyanka Tibrewal said, that the likes of Saket Gokhale or indeed me are communalizing the issue.
Yeah. Well, Rajdeep, in the way you have formulated this, there is a broad generalization which really does not hold good. The Christians as a whole do not resent any attempt on the part of the government to enforce financial transparency and accountability. I personally welcome the most stringent measures provided they are uniformly applied to all sections of the society. Everybody must learn to be honest in managing material resources. And also, personally speaking, and I'm not speaking on behalf of the community, personally, I am not particularly upset if foreign funding is stopped altogether for the reason that the Indian Christian community today is somewhat rich enough to support the activities of missionaries of charity if they so wish. But unfortunately, giving without any expectations is not a particularly well-developed strength in the Indian culture, and that applies also to Christians who are by culture Indians or Hindus, whichever way you like to put it. The churches, for example, in Kerala are immensely rich. But Christians are yet to develop the generosity of the spirit by which they give sacrificially or generously enough to support the noble work that an organization like the Missionaries of Charity is doing. And that's why it becomes so important to get funding from overseas.
Let me just stop you for a moment, because you're making important point that I think need to be taken forward. You know, Priyanka Tibrewal, the worry about this is that the same political parties who will go to the Lok Sabha and say that their foreign funds cannot be brought under scrutiny are desperate to bring missionaries of charity under their scrutiny. Here are funds which, over a track record, this is not an institution which is fly by night. It's been built over years by the likes of Mother Teresa, Sister Nirmala and others. It has worked among the poorest of the poor. I mean, is that due? Somewhere there seems to be an attempt to send out a message is the fear. We've seen what's happened with the conversion bill in Karnataka. We've seen Christian institutions being targeted by the Bajrang Dal in recent weeks. Why is it, therefore, that I should not have the suspicion that the MOC is being singled out?
No one is saying that foreign funds can't come. In fact, when this act was amended in 2016, the FCRA, there are provisions where political parties can also receive these donations. So no one is saying that. But of course, if there are certain criteria and eligibility that you do not meet for renewal, then as per the act, whatever is being done is as per the act. And if you need to challenge that, this media is not the forum. You should proceed in the correct forum. Rather, the missionaries of charity, forget challenging. They have not even gone for a revision as to why this refusal was there.
No, but the worry, Priyanka Tibrewal, I think everyone wants transparency in the way funding is done for organization. No problem with that. But in recent years, we've seen with the Modi government and this Home Ministry that they are putting several NGOs which are seen to be in some way not following, towing the government line under the scanner through using FCRA. The Commonwealth Human Rights Initiative, other groups have been put under the radar, under the garb of FCRA rules. So is the transparency designed to virtually destroy NGOs that may be seen to be in some way critical or dissenters or with alternate views?
You can have a different view regarding the same, but what I will again repeat is that certain things are a matter of investigation. If there is anything wrong, it will come out within under the investigation. And even then, if people have any kind of complaint, they should proceed to the correct forum. If you have any kind of feeling that something unjust is happening, you should proceed. We have law in our land.
You know, Saket Gokhale,
saying that this injustice is being done to you. But yes, whatever is the work of the Ministry of Home Affairs to bring certain things under the radar, to watch that, to investigate, whatever is the work of the agency, they will do the needful.
Okay. Saket Gokhale, you know, this is where the politics comes in. There's a belief that the Trinamool Congress wants to make a mark in Goa. Goa has a large Christian population. You raise this issue of missionaries of charity without the full facts having come into the public domain, with the sole purpose, in a way, of playing vote bank politics of your own. That's the charge which is made. Mamata Banerjee or any leader will have to accept that there are certain rules and norms, FCRA rules, for all NGOs, not just for missionaries of charity.
Let me point out here, Rajdeep, very clearly. Number one, the Chief Minister of West Bengal, Mamata Banerjee, spoke up because St. Teresa was, at her essence, a Bengali. The Missionaries of Charity is an organization from Bengal, very much from Bengal, very much from Kolkata. So I don't see, I mean, it's convenient of the BJP to drag in Goa and other things, but it's a Bengal-based organization, and therefore the Chief Minister spoke up. Number two, it's very easy for the BJP spokesperson to say they should go to the right forum. I mean, today 22,000 people are at risk because the funds have been blocked. Where are they going to go to court from? Who's going to fund the court?
Missionaries
cases
of charities
from?
Have refused.
Number three, I'm sorry, do not interrupt me, please. Do not interrupt me. I did not interrupt you.
Priyanka, let him complete. Priyanka, he did not interrupt you. Priyanka, he did not interrupt you. Let's be fair. Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Number three, they say no revision. The Home Ministry says no revision or, you know, the rectification was made. As the pastor before me clearly pointed out, that, you know, as the Reverend pointed out, in terms of making a revision or making an application, first of all, you have to tell them what the adverse inputs are. You know, this is not because of any compliance filing. This is because of so-called adverse inputs received. Besides, you do this 5 days before the deadline expires. Where is the time to file a revision? And then number four, again, is a question I want to really put it out there today. You know, we are talking about 1,000 crores of foreign funds over some years or whatever. There is the PM CARES fund today, which has 32,000 plus crore rupees. It has an FCRA license. On what grounds is the license being renewed by the Home Ministry? Are they being treated with the same standard? Is an organization with a trust where a Prime Minister Modi is the chairperson, is the Home Ministry treating them with an equal hand as they're treating the missionaries of charity?
The opacity with which the Prime Minister's CARES Fund has operated is a huge question mark. There is a question mark over the manner in which FCRA guidelines are allegedly flouted, or the way the Home Ministry chooses to interpret it across NGOs. But final word from you, Reverend Thampu. The sense one gets is that this is a time where the Christian community finds itself under siege. Is that an exaggeration being done by critics of the Modi government, suggesting that the Modi government is now targeting Christians? Earlier, the charge was that they were targeting Muslims. Now it's the Christians. Do you believe that's an exaggeration, or there is a sense of disquiet on the ground?
There is certainly disquiet on the ground, but it's not the case that every Christian believes that only they are under the scanner or are targeted. For example, those who express their opinions critically and freely are also under the scanner. All those who are inconvenient to the dispensation are under watch. After all, Pegasus issue is still alive. But I have an idea as to why attention is now being trained on Christians. You see, with this somewhat settlement of the Ayodhya Ram Mandir issue, the the usefulness of the Muslim community as a hate object has come down very dramatically. And for the vote bank consolidation, which has become extremely important for the BJP at this point in time in the electoral process, there is a need to aggravate the sense of insecurity, and that's the irony of it, the sense of insecurity of the majority community, that Hinduism is under attack from all corners. And, you know, thousands of missionaries armed with foreign money are out to wipe out Hinduism from the land of this birth. But after all, let's not forget that in 1999, Johann Steins and his two children were burned alive in Manoharpur, Keonjhar district in Orissa, because somebody called Dara Singh sincerely believed that Hinduism was under serious peril because of the activity of a person called Graham Stein. So it's not difficult to whip up this this kind of paranoia among the people. So the irony today is that far more than the minority communities, it's those who pretend to be the custodians of the majority religion who feel in electorally insecure. Mm-hmm. And they're trying to treat their insecurity by generating insecurity among others, by a strange alchemy, they hope would turn into security, electoral security for themselves.
That's an extremely contentious point you're making, that you claim that Christians are now being seen as hate objects in a way for electoral purposes to create that enemy figure. Muslims earlier, you believe, now Christians. Yes, Priyanka Tibrewal, I must give you a final response because that's a very serious charge also, which is being made.
Right. So, as I started, I said that this is nothing but communal provocation, and I will once again say that those who are trying to portray themselves as the well-wishers of missionaries of charity are not concerned about what are the adverse inputs and the reality behind them, but are very much concerned and keen on political mobilization on basis of religion, because their target is only Goa election and nothing else.
Okay, you believe the target is only Goa election, but would you concede that at least what those adverse findings are should be made public? That if the missionaries of charity, according to the government of India, are involved in activities that are inimical in some way to their stated objectives, should that be made public, or should this be
our system is very, very, very transparent on that, Rajdeep sir. Anybody can proceed with an RTI and you will get to know what
would like to add one sentence more.
Okay, yes, Reverend Thampu, what's your final sentence?
Rajdeep, assume that there are adverse reports against the activities of the missionaries of charity. Mm-hmm. Are they not entitled to an opportunity to explain themselves? Mm-hmm. You see, as of now, the way it has happened is that an allegation is made, and the object of allegation or the victims of allegation are virtually de facto condemned without being given an opportunity to explain their position. Secondly, mm-hmm. If a particular branch of a network commits, let's say, an inappropriate thing, an offense, mm-hmm. Should the entire network be penalized? Because after all, when you cut off the funding for the entire network, mm-hmm. it's not merely a particular individual or unit that allegedly misbehaved that suffers. The entire network suffers. It's like bombing a country in order to punish a criminal.
Sure. My bigger worry, of course, is that this sends out the wrong message globally. Across the world, Mother Teresa is revered. She's been a Nobel Peace Laureate, brought great glory in a way to India. And today, when the missionaries of charity find themselves under the scanner, it's going to send out the wrong message across the world.
I want to add something, Rajdeep, here.
Yes, Saket, very quickly, 30 seconds only.
Yeah, because RTI was mentioned right now, and therefore, obviously, I have to respond, which is the Home Ministry doesn't respond to RTIs. They always use Section 8. And just two very quick points I need to mention here, because they're talking about politics and politicizing. Is the BJP A, claiming that the Christians are not in their favor? Number one, because, you know, obviously others are politicizing, they say. Number two, the New York Times 2 days ago did an entire feature, a very in-depth feature on the persecution of Christians in India. Now, is the New York Times contesting Goa elections, or is it a mouthpiece of any of the opposition parties?
Okay, let's leave it there. It's not just the New York Times, but today it's the Wall Street Journal, the Financial Times, the Telegraph of London, all of which have highlighted this issue, which is why I said it's a sensitive issue that needs to be handled with sensitivity. And perhaps it's time to handle it with transparency as well. No one can deny the work of Mother Teresa and missionaries of charity among the poorest of the poor. No one can also deny that politics is often played over such issues. Thank you all very much for joining me here on the news today.
Thank you. Bye.